baby, running my pack. Put some length, bro, all in my way, clear them. Chains ain't making no noise, ain't big enough. Wildin' on a boat on the island. When I better make them go to Thailand. One, I'ma have my fun. T-Cub, I can fit a in my purse. Which one of y'all wanna go first? Spicy, ain't it?
What you doing on this side? Do you know where you at? Let me give you some advice
before you get too attached, baby.
Don't get caught up in the lies, 'cause you won't never make it back. 'Cause this city, this town is so much more than that, baby.
We've got him.
Rabid Memphis fans packed into the FedEx Forum. We'll see the Dallas Mavericks facing the Memphis Grizzlies. We've got some terrific NBA action in store for you today. Kevin Harlan here, joined by our analysts Greg Anthony and Hall of Famer Doris Burke. Plus, reporting from the sidelines, another Hall of Famer, David Aldridge. The Mavericks, GA, have been trying to tighten up their defense the past few seasons, and it's beginning to show.
And we're seeing signs that the players are getting the message, and they're spending more energy at that end of the floor, and that's essential for any elite team.
And Morant gets it to go.
And the contact can't trip Morant up. He just glides past it and into his shot.
Bullock with it. To the paint. Here's Wood. And finished off by Wood.
And he might be small for a center, but boy, can he jump out of the building.
Morant.
Morant.
Score the basket, his second of two attempts.
Man, I'm amazed at Morant's ability to take contact and still stay in full control.
Now, here's Doncic. Shoots over Morant. Morant with some nice D. Score it. His third straight basket in three tries.
Yeah, Steven Adams' instinct is to pass it first, and what instincts he has. Wow, pretty play.
Doncic outside. Six to shoot. Inside. Here's Wood. And the rebound by Jaren Jackson.
Boy, surprised he missed that. The defense just good enough to prevent that bucket.
And it's Morant missing. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Pass to Bullock. Hardaway with it. Dallas needs to get off a shot. Dallas, no good that time either.
Listen, he knows he should have made that shot. We'll see if they can work it back to him in that same area.
And how about that display of athleticism by Morant, flying up in the air for the jam.
Now, here's Doncic. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Ja Morant. That is his first foul of the game.
First team foul.
And the Mavericks are going for a different look here.
JaVale McGee. Dwight Powell. Frank Ntilikina. Spencer Dinwiddie.
Ntilikina looking it over. Down to five on the shot clock. Adams brings the double team. Whoops, there's the 24-second shot clock violation, so they'll turn it over. Now about 3 minutes gone in the first quarter. Here's Morant. Tries again. No good there. So the Mavericks will take it the other way. Back to Dinwiddie. It's Powell on the wing. Dallas moving it around. Down low. And the call on the shot sends him to the line.
Second personal foul.
Endures what you like about Dwight Powell is that he doesn't force anything on offense. Just takes what he has available to him.
He is the perfect role player playing alongside his teammate Luka Doncic for this reason. Excellent screen setter, a real threat vertically at the cup. What a target for Luka.
And Morant throws it down.
How about the handles from the young fellow? Give Morant credit for taking the initiative and capitalizing.
Here's McGee. Played in with a nice touch off the glass.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
And I think defensively, that is not the way you want to start. Giving up high percentage looks, that doesn't typically end well.
And just so many different ways Morant can hurt you. Tonight, it's been with the story.
And that one is good.
And their post play has been really solid right off the bat.
That shot off. Dinwiddie with some nice D. Mavericks trailed by five. Here's Ntilikina. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Pass to Powell. Lays it up and banks it in.
Tell you, even with some physical contact, Powell gets it done. Love his persistence.
And Jackson throws it down hard.
Do a lot more damage to the rim than that when he wants to.
Oh, you're right. And with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one. Pass to Powell. Five on the clock. Back to McGee.
Well, Steven Adams making his presence felt. This guy on the defensive end can be special.
14.
Jump.
The Mavericks. 9. 10. Please give a big round.
And thanks again for tuning in. If you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter of action so far.
Make some noise.
And a moment to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for Memphis.
These guys have been so quick off the dribble, finding great lanes to attack and getting themselves to the basket.
And so Doncic will bring it up for the Dallas Mavericks, trailing by five. Over in the corner, Wood. It's rebounded by Memphis.
And you know, for proof of what Morant's done for the Memphis franchise, look at the offensive numbers. Grizzlies have made huge steps forward every year.
Brooks, that's a two-pointer. Adams' shot is off. Mavericks trailed by five. Near the three-point line, it's Doncic. And the rebound by Jaren Jackson. Greg, the improvement since Morant arrived has been very steady.
And the Grizzlies went from the 20th rated offense in his rookie season to number 16 in his second year, and then all the way up to number 5 last season. Ja has turned them into a powerhouse.
Pass to Finney-Smith. Now, here's Doncic. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Dallas again missing.
He is single-handedly dropping the temperature in here with that cold streak.
He is trying to shoot his way out of it, and it might be better for him to pass the basketball at this point.
Finney-Smith off target with his three. Morant with it. He's picked up by Doncic. Pass to Bane. to the inside. Here's Jackson. Basket is good. He'll get a chance for one more at the line.
And here's a guy that's not in coast mode. Jackson is going to give it all he has every minute he's on the floor. That's how he earns the amber.
Boy, what a season 2022 was for the Dallas Mavericks, making it all the way to the Western Conference Finals. Obviously, the huge upset over the Suns turned that season into what was a dream run early in Luka Doncic's career.
Now, here's Doncic. Good on the shot.
Luka Doncic.
6'7", 230 pounds. Luka Doncic is a load in the painted area.
Morant drives in. That shot is good. He has made 8 while missing only 4. That's 67% shooting. And with the Mavs, a trip doors to the conference finals puts them ahead of schedule, many people think.
Yes, Kevin, but I don't think you can let that momentum you built last year fade in any way. You've got to keep your foot on the gas pedal. We know how fragile success in the NBA is. You've got a top 5 player on your roster. You have to make sure you're taking advantage of opportunities.
Now here's Brooks. After the miss from Christian Wood, there's Jackson with the 3. Misses that one. His first miss of the night. 2 for 3. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
Substitution on the court.
1:39 left in the first half. Now Jones. Pass to Brooks. Pulls up from the corner, and it doesn't even draw iron.
All alone from mid-range. They know he won't miss many of those.
And Hardaway gets it to go. Hardaway has got it back down to single digits for the Mavs.
Well, you want to be able, as a scorer, to put it on the deck to create your shot. Go ahead, Mr. Hardaway. We see you getting off the bounce.
Now, here's Dinwiddie. After the miss from Desmond Bain. Pass to Kleba. Knocks it loose. Outside, Bain. That drops and it comes off an assist from Brooks. Bain's got the lead up to 10 now for the Grizzlies.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flame.
One thing I enjoy is watching players who don't pay attention to the score. You lock in on the moment and play the right way.
And the Grizzlies leading by 10. Pass to Clark. No good with the layup. And so it's Memphis with a
4. Your Grizzlies 23.
And happy you could join us. We've got 2 quarters left to go in regulation. Well, we know the NBA has worked to get rid of the hard foul. The business in the league has done a great job of doing that. What has contributed, though, to that line of thinking?
Well, I think any play can be reviewed, Kevin, and that's a good thing, because if it's a non-basketball play, then you open yourself up to a flagrant 2. The punishment is significant enough to discourage the action. I love the rule changes as it relates to this particular infraction.
Here's Bane after Luka Doncic's bucket.
Definitely a situation you want to make sure you don't give him too good of a look.
It's stolen by Jones. Here's Brooks. The offensive rebound. Here's Conchar. And the shot goes in. Conchar's got his first points of the game.
Well, this is what he does. Find ways to make his presence felt, then this time on the offensive glass.
How about the hustle on display there? That kind of effort will earn respect from everyone.
To the middle. Here's Finney Smith. And the officials calling for a 3-second violation.
He got a little ahead of himself there trying to pull the team even.
Well, that's a big miscue, and you hate to see that happen at this point in the game.
Now here's Morant. The 12-point lead, their biggest of the game. 4 on the clock. Shoots. Second chance shot. Adams' shot is off. Mavericks trail by 12 to the left side wing. Bertans can't get it to go. And Adams has got the ball here for the Grizzlies. They've only allowed 2 points so far here in the second half. And let's head over to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Thanks very much. Now, from the step back to his attacking style, some have compared Luka Doncic to the beer, James Harden. There are some similarities, Harden said. Being able to dictate and control the game like he does, he never lets anyone speed him up, and he gets what he wants. Back to you, Kevin.
He always has. They're both pretty fun to watch, David. Thank you. Now, Morant. After Luka Doncic's three-pointer that didn't go.
Just rubbing it in their faces with that dunk.
He is never going to take his foot off the pedal.
Well, you love that he wants to wear out the defense. What a catalyst for his team. Incredible.
Well done.